A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 12th November, on the front page you have Sena denied more time, NCP's turn now. So the governor has refused Sena's plea for 3 more days to produce letters of support, and now Congress and NCP are in a huddle because it is NCP's turn now to be given a chance to form the government. And here you have, this is forming government in Maharashtra after BJP has decided not to stake claim. And Sena is also not able to put in the numbers and is refused more time. Then next is IIP shrinks by 4.3% to lowest in 8 years. So this is regarding index of industrial production. So for the month of September 2019, IIP contracted sharply by 4.3%. Means it is minus 4.3% IIP growth. And it is driven by major slowdowns in the capital goods, mining and manufacturing sectors. So this is lowest in 8 years. It is said all 3 major sectors have shown contraction. Then on page 4 you have Center begins work on NCR Regional Plan 2041. So setting the goals for enhancing livability, economic activity and sustainability of National Capital Region of Delhi, the process of preparing a 20-year plan, that is a regional plan for 2041. That is by 2021, this will be a 20-year plan will be in place by 2021. So the process here has been started by the government, the central government. On page 8 you have narrow escape for passengers. So this is Falaknuma train in Hyderabad which collided with Secunderabad bound Hundri Express. So passengers here had a miraculous escape. It was a head-on collision, you can see. This is a mangled MMTS coach, that is multimodal transport system train coach. So this shown. Then below you have Suranga Bavadi enters World Monument watch list. So this water supply structure will now get funds for restoration. It's an internal part of the ancient Karej system of supplying water through subterranean tunnels. It was built during Adil Shahi era in Karnataka's Vijayapura. So, it would get funding for restoration. Now, a New York based NGO has included it in the World Monument Watch List for 2020. There are 24 other monuments in this list across the world. On page 9, you have Center forms committee to draft new water policy. So, this is Union Water Resource Ministry which has finalized a committee to draft new national water policy. It will be chaired by Mihir Shah, who is former planning commission member. So the committee is expected to produce a report within 6 months. So national water policy currently in force was drafted in 2012. So major innovations in this present policy was the concept of integrated water resources management approach that took the river basin, sub basin as a unit for planning. So planning, development and management was per, river basin or sub basin. It also proposed that a portion of river flow ought to be kept aside to meet ecological needs, the ecological flow concept. So that was also under the National Water Policy of 2002. Then here you have anemia among men, a major public health issue. So it is said at least 23.2% men are affected by anemia. According to a study here, anemia among men in India. So anemia is actually iron deficiency. So mostly focuses on women and children, but this is a study which shows that anemia prevails among men in India as well. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the extra mile. So this is regarding Kartarpur corridor which has been inaugurated. It says that the corridor has realized the dream of devout Sikhs but done little for India-Pakistan ties. So for religious, Sikh religion as such, it is a boon, but it has not resulted in any thaw between India-Pakistan relations. And below you have casting the net wide. So this is regarding Kerala's plan for providing free internet access to the poor. So this editorial says that this action is worthy of emulation by others. Free internet access for poor. The lead article, several positives for the Muslim plaintiffs. So this article says that minorities and defenders of the rule of law and secularism need not feel disappointed with the Ayodhya verdict. There are several positives in the verdict too. Is the detail given regarding the Supreme Court verdict, you can see. There is a worry that VHP, which claims to in respect of 3000 other mosques that you know they were also built on temples. So this is going to result in a huge furor if such actions are taken against other mosques in the country too. So on that count, it is said that the verdict of the Supreme Court in Ayodhya case comes as a relief, because on freedom of religion, the court said that we must firmly reject any attempt to lead the court to interpret religious doctrine in an absolute and extreme form and question the faith of worshippers. Then also court accepted Sunni Waqf Board's plea that the place of Lord Ram's birth is not in itself a juristic pursuit. So this was a major setback to Ram Lalla. Also, Supreme Court categorically accepted the central argument of the Muslim plaintiffs that mosque was not constructed after demolition of a Ram temple. Also, court said that Archaeological Survey of India report has not found any evidence of demolition of a temple to construct a mosque. Also, court said that per the ASI report, remnants of a pre-existing structure were not used for construction of the mosque. So, even the black kasauti stone pillars as such, the court held that ASI in fact found no evidence to show that the pillars were relatable to underlying pillar bases found during the excavation. Also, it says that since Muslim plaintiffs did not claim title in this case, the outcome is in their favor, because relief sought by them was about delivery of possession. So, since the court did accept that they were wrongly deprived of their possession in 1949 and they should get possession of the land, so court has provided 5 acres land to the Muslims. So, that is also there. Then, this is regarding furor in Pakistan. So it is Maulana Fazlur Rahman of Pakistan, of Jamaat-e-Ulema-Islam of Pakistan. He has brought together protesters and also opposition parties together against the government of Imran Khan, against the army, because he says army supported him and he won the elections. They are calling for elections again. On op-ed page you have a missed opportunity in Ayodhya. So this article says that the court, Supreme Court verdict in Ayodhya case, it missed an opportunity. It could have used Article 142 to prohibit any further claims against other places of worship, but such mention was not there in the verdict. And we had seen regarding this OCI case, Atish Tasir, he is a writer whose OCI was revoked, Overseas Citizen of India card was revoked. And this case, at it says, brings in focus outdated provisions of Citizenship Amendment Act. So the provisions which are there under OCI, Overseas Citizens of India card, which was launched in 2005. So it was to give foreign citizens of Indian origin almost a citizen-like status. So they can visit India multiple times for multiple purposes, also exempted from reporting to police authorities. So such benefits are there. But then Mr. Tasir was denied OCI card, and this brings in the possibility of similar treatment being meted out to orphans, adopted children, children born to single mothers, etc. That point is highlighted. He was denied OCI card because his mother is a Muslim, but his father is a Pakistani. His mother is he's an Indian, but his father is a Pakistani. On that basis, but they were never married. And he never lived with his father, but since his father is from Pakistan, he was denied OCI card. So if children are born to single mothers, how would they be treated under OCI is a question raised. On page 13 you have trains to run again in Valley. So train services were stopped after central government revoked Jammu Kashmir's special status on 5th August. But now train services in Kashmir will resume. This is what the Railway Ministry has announced. So they were stopped for nearly 3 months now. And here you have Jammu and Kashmir police stripped of prosecution wing. So in the new Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, the police have been stripped of the prosecution wing. Earlier, police officers could appear in magisterial courts as public prosecutors. So this arrangement stands quashed now. And below you have capacity building program for Afghan diplomats begin. So, Indian and Chinese officials began a course to train diplomats from Afghanistan at Foreign Services Institute, which is in Delhi. run by the External Affairs Ministry. So this is a 2-week intensive program launched in presence of Chinese ambassador to India. Then on international page you have Morales exit knocks Bolivia into a vacuum. So Bolivian President Evo Morales said he was resigning to ease violence that has gripped the South American nation since a disputed election. But he stoked fears of more unrest by saying he was victim of a coup. So shops and properties have been attacked, gangs roam streets, and opposition senators have been offered to be interim president. So this is the situation in Bolivia. And here you have elections in Spain, the results as such, which show the ruling Socialist Party of Prime Minister Pedro Sanchez, the election as such, which is fourth election since 2015, has again failed to secure a majority. The far-right Vox Party came to at a third place in this election. It more than doubled the number of MPs in Spain. And this is man set on fire in a day of Hong Kong fury. So police shot a masked protester, aggravating the protesters, and it has paralyzed the city of Hong Kong. The masked protester was shot in an incident which was shown live on Facebook. The man was set on fire during one of the most violent days of clashes in Hong Kong. On business page you have Australia still hopes India will join RCEP. So ex-Australian secretary says that India's entry into the trade bloc is dependent on India-China element. So that is evident. And this is passenger vehicle sales pick up after 11 months. So new models have spurred utility vehicles. And now passenger vehicle sales is seeing a marginal increase. So then the last page has sports related news. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.